subscribe to my YouTube channel, and follow me on Twitch.
Hogsmeade, here I come. Slow down now. There we go.
I'll fix him, that charm grinder.
No, that's awesome.
Hello, pardon me.
Pardon me?
Hello there. Was there something you needed?
Hello. I was wondering if you would be interested in having your own shop and a house elf to help you with it. Penny's the name. Penny's mistress is selling this shop. And Penny is most eager to start working with the new owner. It might surprise you to know that Penny can sell practically anything.
Even with your help, I'm not certain it would be worth it. Shopkeeping has never really appealed to me.
Oh, but think of the galleons you could earn. You'll be able to give Penny almost anything that you want to sell. It will be no work at all for you once the shop is up and running. If you want the shop, and Penny hopes that you do, you should talk to Penny's mistress as soon as you can. Her name is Cassandra Mason.
Why is your mistress selling the shop? And you?
Penny cannot be certain, as Mistress Mason so rarely confides in her. However, she repeatedly mentions how tired she has become of trying to let the shop. She has had rotten bad luck with the last few tenants.
Are you all right? Are you holding your breath?
Penny's fine. Sometimes Penny simply needs to remind herself to stop talking.
What kind of things would I be able to sell in the shop?
All kinds. Anything from Essence of Dittany to Mooncalf Fur. If a buyer exists for something, then Penny can sell it and get the best price. Just ask Mistress Mason.
Why are the premises in such disarray?
Oh, the previous tenants were not able to manage very well. They seem to have given up rather quickly. Penny is perfectly capable of helping clean and repair, so the shop will be ready for business in no time.
She is terrible.
How is it you're so good at selling? Seems unusual for a house elf.
Oh, before he died, Penny's previous owner, Master Mason, trusted her to do all sorts of things to help him with his shop. Penny supposes it is a bit unusual for a house elf to possess such skill, but Master Mason commanded it, and Penny was happy to oblige. Master Mason was a wonderful master.
All right, I shall go and find Madam Mason.
Oh, this is splendid news indeed. You won't be sorry. You can find Mistress Mason at her home on the north edge of the village. Penny does hope she gets to work with you.
Revelio. Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade. Now, demiguys.
Come on, it's night time. You should be.
Hello, Madam Mason. I understand you have a shop to sell.
Yes. Yes, I do. Are you interested?
Perhaps. It depends upon your terms.
I think you will find my terms quite generous. But, and do please forgive me for asking, don't you think you might be a tad young to own a shop?
I am quite capable of owning a shop, I can assure you. I should think you'd be happy to have a buyer.
Well, I reckon you have the confidence needed for such a venture. And of course you'll have Penny to help you. That elf could sell tea to a troll. I assume she told you she comes with the place.
She did indeed.
I like you. Tell you what, I shall sell you the space for an exceedingly fair price. I think you might just be shrewd enough to make a go of it.
An exceedingly fair price for a shop and an elf. What's the catch?
You are wise to be wary in business dealings. No catch, really. I simply ask that you allow me to do you the favour of buying the shop back. At a discount, of course, should your efforts fail. The last thing we need here in Hogsmeade is for one bad apple to spoil the barrel, if you get my meaning.
Your faith in me is overwhelming. You're sorely mistaken if you think I'm going to fail.
There's that confidence again. And, of course, I wish you every success. Do we have a deal?
What precisely do you mean, should my efforts fail?
Honestly, I only mean that if for some reason you're unable to keep the shop going, I could help you cut your losses. That's all. But, as you've implied, the odds of that happening are remote.
The shop seems to be in an ideal location. Why has no one purchased it yet?
It is indeed. But I've just decided to sell. I've grown weary of being a landlady. My late husband was the one with a passion for shopkeeping and business in general. You'd be wise to take advantage of this opportunity before the offers start rolling in.
It looks to be rather a mess. Why haven't other tenants been able to make a go of it there?
As you've no doubt considered, running a shop is not as simple as those less savvy might think. The new owner, however, will have something that previous tenants did not. The benefit of Penny's particular prowess. Her assistance will make all the difference, I should think, in both getting the shop ready for business and ensuring its success.
It does sound intriguing, but I need to consider my finances first. I'll come and find you if I'm interested.
Very well. But I won't be able to keep the shop available for too long. If you do want the shop, I'd advise you to return to me as soon as possible. Hello again. You know, the shop won't be available forever. Penny is terribly keen to put her business acumen into use. I do hope we're able to do business together.
Madam Mason, about the shop.
Yes?
I've decided I'd like to go ahead and purchase the shop.
I have to say I'm impressed. You are a remarkably resourceful student.
I am indeed.
And brave. You won't be sorry. Give me the money and I shall get the paperwork filed immediately.
Wonderful. Shall I head directly to the shop?
Please do. Oh, one more thing. Since my husband died, I've not been able to bring myself to retrieve some of his personal items. They're in a chest at the back of the shop. Penny has the key. As you get organised, I would be terribly grateful if you could help an old widow and gather his things for me before you open for business. I wish you the very best of luck in your endeavours. Penny will meet you there.
Well, I've done it, Penny. The shop is mine.
Oh, Penny is so pleased. Penny was hoping you would be the one to purchase it.
I'm glad you're here to help me.
Goodness, what a kind thing to say. Penny will do all that she can to make this a success. There is much to do. The last tenant left in a bit of a rush, so we'll need to clean up and do some repairs.
Wonderful. I can only imagine what we might find in there.
It is most certainly nothing that you and Penny can't handle together. Shall we? Between the two of us, we should have this place up and running in no time.
Prepare.
Can already see the potential. Nothing like a bit of hard work. Mistress Mason wanted Penny to be sure and give you this key. It opens a chest in the back room of this shop.
Oh, yes. She mentioned it to me. It contains some of her late husband's belongings.
Penny wonders if you should open the chest.
Are you holding your breath again?
Penny must get back to work now.
Revelio. Revelio. did someone store one hat in here? Revelio. Not very hospitable.
Bombarda!
Oh, goody! Someone to play with! You seem to have your wits about you. What fun this will be!
For me, at least.
Lumos. That's new. Onwards, I suppose. What in the... Who's there? That's lovely. Seems as if I should hang something there. Revelio. These lanterns must belong somewhere. The lanterns are meant to be hung on the hands. Revelio.
How enlightening! You might survive a bit longer than the others.
Lumos.
Thank you.
Ravenia.
Oh, you've come so far, so quickly. Well done. You might be just the playmate I've been looking for. I do hope you enjoy my playground. I encourage you to tell everyone about it, if you make it out, that is. Please try. If you get to the end, perhaps we can come to some sort of arrangement. I do want your shop to succeed, after all. What's the saying? Two sides to every story. Unfortunately for you, both sides here are to my story. So you'll have to complete both to get to the end.
Ravenia.
I simply adore this blooming place, don't you? You know, foliage, like most living things, won't survive for long in the darkness.
I wonder if I need to place lanterns to open these doors.
Oh, I'm afraid of the dark. Does it worry you that I can see you, but you can't see me?
Wingardium Leviosa.
It should. I'd offer you a seat, but I'm rearranging the furniture. But don't want you getting too comfortable for what's in store, do I?
Repair. Velio. Ravenia.
Ah, a worthy playmate. Well done.
Velio.
Ravenia.
What's this? A game within a game? Ooh, ooh! Knight to H3. Nighty night!
Ravenia. Ravenia.
That wasn't too difficult.
Oh, goodness! I do hope you're having as much fun as me. I think I'll keep you around a bit longer.
Revelio.
You've chosen Rebellion. The scholarly bit. You'll need more than you've learned from books to best me.
Lumos.
Deja vu. Deja vu. What?
Lumos.
Running in circles, are we? Perhaps you should retrace your steps.
Lumos. What was that?
Nice of him to pop in.
Home, sweet home.
It's always good to have a different perspective on things.
Lumos. Ravenia.
Books and no play make one quite dull indeed.
Oh!
fun. I'll give you a moment to connect yourself, if you can. Ta-ta for now!
Revelio.
Inordinately clever friend appear to have traversed this seemingly never-ending dungeon relatively unscathed. And now I suppose you want to go. Everyone leaves me, usually in a straitjacket, never to return. I'm starting to take it personally. I'm tired of having no one to play with. Ooh. Ooh. Tell you what, I'll make you a deal. If you can match wits with me now and agree to give me unfettered access to the shop for, say, one day a month to have a little fun, I'll sign a contract. Pursuant to which, let me see, I will blah, 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 blah. Oh, yes, they'll leave you and your customers alone at all other times, etc., etc. You get your shop, I get my chaos. Sound acceptable? Excellent! Let the games begin!
Captain,
Someone deserving of the playground I so meticulously crafted. Such a treat to have fun again in my little dungeon.
You wouldn't call it fun, really.
Wouldn't you? To each their own, I suppose.
So, about that contract.
I am a poltergeist of my word.
Just to be clear, what does this agreement entail, specifically?
Pay attention. You guarantee that I can have my fun at least one day each month without fuss. I let you work the rest of the time, mostly, in peace.
Why would you enter into such an agreement?
Much as I love banging about the place, it's no comparison to seeing customers' faces when I bonk them on the heads with a chocolate frog. But one doesn't really understand the value of an audience until one is without it.
Very well. I shall agree to your contract. With one small addendum.
Hooray! No more of this unsatisfying banging about all day in a pitiful void. Wait, did you say one small addendum?
I did. In order that I have a successful shop with lots of customers, would you agree to causing chaos only after 9 o'clock in the evening?
Would you agree to at least 2 days a month instead of one?
I would.
Pleasure doing business with you. You've worn me out. Well done. I had a feeling about you. I have to admit, Cassandra did a wonderful job finding the perfect playmate.